Hi, we're the AFTC5 simulation team, and this is our multidisciplinary senior design project sponsored by Alstom. Alstom leads the world in train signaling technology, and one such technology developed by Alstom is the audio frequency track circuit, AFTC5, computer, which is comprised of multiple analog signal generators called TCUs. The analog signals generated by each TCU are used to send and detect critical information to and from train cars. This diagram shows a typical AFTC5 configuration. The signal from each TCU is transmitted through a series of filtering transformers, known as Wheezy Bonds, and ultimately through the track circuit, which represents the electrical characteristics of the train tracks, including the train moving across it. To test this technology, it's important that the AFTC5 system is tested under electrical conditions representative of what it may encounter in the field. Currently, this is accomplished by connecting the AFTC5 system to the actual Wheezy Bonds used in the field. These bonds are heavy, with each combined testing configuration potentially weighing hundreds of pounds. Additionally, the track circuit is modeled with just a few basic electrical components. These filters combined make it incredibly difficult to build versatile testing configurations for the AFTC5 device. For every test case that needs to be executed, the bonds need to be physically rearranged. The bulky size of the bonds make it difficult to test more than a few TCUs at any given time, and the fixed value electrical components used to model the track circuits make it difficult to simulate a continuous motion, such as a train moving across a track. With these issues in mind, we set out to build a highly reconfigurable device capable of simulating the electrical response of multiple track circuits and bonds simultaneously. To accomplish this task, our team replaced the filtering portion of the traditional configuration with a microcontroller-based digital filter. For ease of usability, the filter on each microcontroller can be configured using a single USB-enabled master device. One particular challenge our team faced during the design process was that the program used to convert physical track properties into electrical component values was only available as a closed-source Fortran program, which only ran inside an MS-DOS emulation. Supporting this system would be a challenging and time-consuming process, and ultimately, our team decided to write a script that would run this conversion program for every combination of input values within a given range. The output data from this program was saved to a file so that it could be referenced later. We'd like to thank our client and sponsor, Alstom, for taking the time to regularly meet with us and provide helpful feedback and resources. We'd also like to thank several members of the RIT faculty for their guidance on this project. Thank you.